Another video. This time I'm going to share to you Moodle blocks. A Moodle block contains a feature that loads in a right side or left side of the course homepage. So blocks in Moodle are special, let's say, widgets that you can incorporate into your class that would allow you to, let's say, see the current calendar, who is currently, let's say, logged in. What's the result of the quiz? What's the who are, let's say, on this side, section links and so on. Okay, so this is very essential in your course. Okay, so let's create now. Let's incorporate Moodle blocks into your course. To do that, let's log in now to your course. By the way, there is a section here for logging in into your Gmail account. Since we have issued already your MDSF email, so kindly try out to log in via Gmail. So you don't need to type here your username and password. So in my case, I have here set as no, so that the system identifies me already. But there's another way. If you could click this one, you could automatically log in using your Gmail account. So this time I'm going to demonstrate using the teacher's account. I'm going to log in. And then here, I'm currently in my dashboard, okay? So the dashboard shows us the recently accessed courses that we have. So in this case, I have recently accessed this course, LMS Trainee, and also some of the courses that I am enrolled with or I'm assigned as the teacher. So example, we have here the following courses. Either be I'm the teacher or also I'm the students. So in this section, you can still customize this by adding blocks, okay? So to do that, let's say we would like to customize our desktop, our dashboard. If you notice, there is a customize this page. Click on this one, okay? So it means that you could add changes to your dashboard. Now look, on this side, I have here add a block, okay? If I click here, add a block, these are the different blocks that is available to me, okay? So let's say I would like to know first the latest announcements, or let's say who is currently logged in, or if let's say I'm a teacher, I would like to see all upcoming events. Let's say in a course, I have set already, let's say, 3 quizzes or assignments, and I like to know which one is due already, so I could be notified with that. So let's say I'm going to select here upcoming events. Again, you could reach this or you could view this by, if I go back here, first thing that you have to do, click here, customize this page. After that, the block, add a block will appear. Click on add a block and then select the items here. So I'm going to select here upcoming events. So once you select upcoming events, you would notice that this item here appeared. Okay, so the icon, this blue icon here, shows the hide blocks. Okay, so by default it's not there, but if you try to add here blocks, you can see this icon this already. So for example, upcoming events, I have here several activities. Let's say this one opens tomorrow at 1:53, opens on Monday, and the following assignments activities are due. Okay, if you go to your calendar, here you would see the calendar events for different activities inside your course. Okay, so again, let's go back to our course, go to our dashboard. Okay, then we could still add additional blocks. So add blocks here, and then let's say I would like to know who is currently online. So in this case, I will just select here online users, click on this one, and then online users will automatically be listed here. Okay, next, let's add another one. Let's say I would like to have latest announcements. Click on latest announcements, and then scroll down, you will see here the latest announcement. You could also move the blocks here. If you see this icon here, click, hold, and drag you can automatically move the blocks depending on your customization. Okay, depending on how you would like to see the blocks here. Okay, so that is within your dashboard. So stop customizing this page, and then every time that you open it, you will see this icon here. Then you would be able to know the latest events, upcoming events, and then online users. Let's now go inside the course. So I have here inside my course. So by default, there are no blocks that are available. Okay. So let's now add a block here. First thing is that you need to click the gear icon and then turn editing on. So once you click turn editing on this side, you're going to see here add a block. Take note, this time you're going to add blocks that your students would see. Okay, so let's say add a block. So what do we need to add? First thing is that you need to always add your upcoming events. So if there are due dates, students will be notified. Click on this one again. Once you click, it will appear on this side here. So there are no upcoming events. Okay, later we're going to try one out. Next is who are currently online. Okay, online or login users. Oh no, this is my account, sorry. Okay, so if you mistakenly add a block here, you could remove it by click on the gear icon, drop down list, and then just simply delete login block. Okay, and then just press yes here. Okay, sorry for that. Let's have another one. Log users, online users. Okay, currently, since I'm in my class, I'm the only user that is currently logged in. But I'm going to open another window. Okay, I'm going to open another window here and then log in. Wait for a while so that you'll see. Okay, I'm going to log in as the student inside my class. So currently, if you notice here, I'm the only one logged in. If I go to my LMS course, okay, am I a student here? Okay, let me check. Okay, where is that? Oh yes, I'm a student here. So currently, I'm logged in as the student. If I refresh this, let's check. Okay, there are now two online users. One is the student, and then the other one is the teacher. So if I'm going to show you the window, this is the other window that I have opened for my students. Okay, so if you use that block, you'll be able to see who are currently logged in or online users inside your class. Okay, so what else? Let's add another block here. What else? You could also include here your calendars. Okay, we have here calendars if you like to. What else? Activity completion, feedbacks. Well, anyway, you could try to add different blocks here depending on your need. You just check this one. Let's try out now an activity. So as you can see, there are no upcoming events. Now, if I scroll down here, add a block. And let's say I'm going to have here a assignment. So this is an assignment. Test assignment using test assignment na lang. Okay, I'm just going to copy and paste this one. If you like to display this. Now, allow submission. Let's say it would be okay, let's have it like that. Okay, and let's just save it. Okay, then after that, if you go back to your block here, you're going to see here upcoming events, test assignment, which is this one, and then you're going to see that the due is on Saturday, May 23. Okay, So on the side of the student, if I could, if I will be showing to you the screen, currently this is the student's side. Currently this is the student. If I refresh this, okay, the student will also be notified that there is an upcoming event, which is an assignment due on May 23rd, 2020. Okay, then if I go to my calendar here, I will be seeing here my upcoming events.